All right, this is a very important video and I've been trying to get this right a few times. I think I'm finally ready, so let's do it. Today, we are going to learn about racing rules of sailing number 14, 15, and 16, or the general limitations on right-of-way boats. These are extremely important to know and basically all come down to the golden rule, which is don't hit each other, just don't do it. And it's everybody's responsibility who's on the water and on the race course to avoid contact and to not hit each other. So first we're gonna talk about some definitions, next we'll read the rules, and then we'll go through some scenarios just to clarify some things for you guys, okay? Let's do it. So number one is a little checklist of conditions that prove a boat is keeping clear. So in any situation, there between two boats, there is a right-of-way boat and a keep clear boat. And we use the rules to say what each of these boats must do. What are their obligations under the rules? So let's see. Number one, a boat keeps clear of a right-of-way boat when the right-of-way boat can hold their course without any avoiding action. So without having to avoid the keep clear boat. So let's see. Can they go straight? Yep, they can go straight. So check on that. And number two, the right-of-way boat can alter course in both directions without immediate contact. So they can head up and there's not immediate contact. They can head down and there's not immediate contact. Check. Now, that doesn't mean there won't be eventual contact. It won't, if you head up and wait 5 seconds, then there will maybe a collision. Right? But immediate means you head up and hit them, right? You head up and hit them. If you head up and then give them, and this is what we're going to talk about next is room to avoid, then that's okay, right? But can you head up or down and not hit each other? If you were right here, the windward boat could head up and hit you, and therefore the keep clear boat was not keeping clear. So we need to give ourselves a little bit more space, and now we'll get to that. So room is the space and time that a boat needs to comply with her rules obligations in an immediate and responsible way, or prompt and seemingly way. What does that mean? Well, when we talk about this acquire right of way, when we change course, whatever, we, the right of way boat always needs to give the keep clear boat room to avoid her immediately, right? And the keep clear boat needs to avoid the right of way boat immediately, okay? So this immediately thing is really important. And we saw in our high school practice the other day when we were doing some team racing that the keep clear boat was taking forever to avoid when, say, a lured boat was luffing them. You have to do it immediately. It's in the rule book, okay? So, rule 14, the golden rule. Give a little, star here. Avoiding contact. Boats shall avoid contact if reasonably possible. That's part one. Part two is the right-of-way boat, or the boat that has room, does not need to do anything to avoid until it's clear that the keep-clear boat is not keeping clear or giving mark room. And at that point, basically, they must avoid contact. Shall, by the way, in legal terms, means is the same thing as must. So we're going upwind on converging courses like this. We're coming together and the keep clear boat is the port boat, keep clear, and this is the right of way boat. So boats must avoid contact, but the right of way boat doesn't need to do anything initially. So if the keep clear boat does their job, they will go down and dock, or they maybe could tack, right? No issues there, everyone followed rule 14, we're good. However, what happens if the keep clear boat breaks rule 14? What do we do as the starboard tack boat or the right of way boat? So initially, no need to keep clear. Then we realize, holy crap, we're on a collision course. What does the right of way boat do? Well, if possible, they could do a big duck and duck the keep clear boat, or they could tack. And once you complete the tack and there's no contact, you yell, And once you yell protest, there's a big chance that this sport boat is going to get disqualified afterwards. And so therefore, we need to avoid the contact and protest. Avoid the contact and then protest. Avoid the contact and then protest. Do not hit each other. If you ended up hitting each other, say another variation on this, you could actually get disqualified as well as the port boat because you could have done something to avoid the contact. So just understand that there doesn't need contact to be a penalty because we violated Rule 14. Now let's talk about Rule 15, which is acquiring right of way. When a boat acquires right of way, they shall initially give the other boat room to keep clear, unless she acquires because of another boat's actions. So let's look at another scenario. We have two boats going downwind, overlapped. The green boat is the right-of-way boat, and the red boat is the keep-clear boat. Well, the red boat says, hey, I think there's great pressure on the course left, and I'd really like to jibe, so I'm going to jibe. The red boat jibes and makes contact, and red boat protests. Well, in this case, the red boat would get thrown out for causing the contact and violating Rule 15. So what's a better thing to do? Well, if we really want to jibe, we should give the green boat a little bit more room. So maybe we head up first, and then we jibe. And now that they see us coming, they have some time to either make an avoiding action by ducking, or they can jibe out of the way. Right? So we give them enough time and space. Now what about when you acquire because of another boat's actions? So let's look at that. So we have two boats on converging courses. So we have the red boat and the green boat. And right now, because of Rule 12, the red boat is the right-of-way boat and the green boat is the keep-clear boat. Well, what happens next? Well, the green boat acquires right of way by becoming the leeward overlapped boat. So now, red boat has to keep clear. Now they continue to come together until they get to this position. And now, red starts avoiding, but they can't avoid because they're too close. And red may protest and argue that the green boat violated 15 by not giving them room to keep clear initially. However, actually, they acquired right of way because of the actions of the red boat, and therefore, this red boat wasn't entitled to that room. They should have started avoiding sooner. So what do we do in this scenario? Do we continue on this converging course and hit each other if the red boat isn't keeping clear? No. We avoid the contact and protest. We avoid the contact and protest. We avoid the contact and protest. I'm going to write it down right here. Avoid contact and protest. Okay, if you take one thing away from this lesson, avoid the contact and protest. Okay, that's how we do it. Now, finally, we're going to get to Rule 16, which is a two-part fun, right? 16.1 says, when a right-of-way boat changes course, she shall initially give the other boat room to keep clear. Same thing, similar to the acquiring right-of-way. So let's look at 16.1. So two boats are going downwind together. They're parallel. Let's see, initially, the green boat is the keep clear boat, and the red boat is the right-of-way boat. So now, is the green boat keeping clear initially? Well, the red boat can go straight. The red boat can alter in either direction and be fine. So therefore, initially, the green boat's keeping clear. Well, let's see what happens next. The red boat luffs very sharply and makes contact. Who's in the right? Well, the green boat is the keep clear boat, and they didn't keep clear. Well, according to Rule 16.1, when the right-of-way boat changes course, she has to give the other boat enough room to keep clear. So instead of this sharp, unexpected luff, we do a little bit, give them the room to keep clear, then we do a little bit more, give them the room to keep clear, and continue, right? Think of it as, 16.1, think of it as each of you has a move, right? So instead of making a big continuous course change, we make a course change, they respond. We make a course change, they respond. We make a course change, they respond. That's how you luff another boat, okay? This is really important, really, really important stuff. So I'll give it a little start. And now 16.2 is just for one very specific case. So we'll go over that really quickly and then call it a video, okay? So 16.2 says upwind, if a port tack boat is keeping clear by sailing to pass to leeward of the starboard tack boat, like here, the starboard tack boat may not bear away if the port tack boat has to immediately change course to keep clear. So the red boat cannot, if the green boat is sailing to pass their stern, the red boat cannot do that and make them keep going, and then eventually they have to jump, right? This was a rule that was implemented in the current rule set, and it used to not be a thing. People used to do, this is called a dial down. It's the dial down rule. People used to do this in team racing all the time, but it's not allowed. So if you're going upwind as a starboard tack boat and the port tack boat decides to duck you, you're kind of frozen in place. What about, we're sailing on convergent courses. Well, are they sailing to duck us? No, they are not. So what can we do? Well, we can bear off at their bow. Now they get to, quarter 16.1. They give them some room to keep clear. They keep clear. And now that they're sailing behind our stern, we have to go back to our proper course. Does that make sense? So one more time. Upwind, if a port tack boat is keeping clear by sailing to pass the leeward of the starboard tack boat may not bear away if the port tack boat has to immediately change course to keep clear. What if they're further away and we point here and they point behind us? Then we can get a little bit closer, but again, we still have to go back upwind. Okay. So anyway, that's the video. Hope this helped you guys out on some stuff. The one thing I really, really want you to understand is that avoiding contact is on, is the responsibility of both the keep clear and the right of way boat. And if contact occurs, then it could potentially lead to both boats getting thrown out. A better thing to do is to avoid the contact and protest. That is much better. So thanks for watching. Next video.